Hello, Ever After High fans. I'm going to review the new sugar-coated Holly O'Hare doll that arrived today in our new doll collection. This line is all about putting dolls in delectably yummy clothes and shoes, and I cannot wait to get her out. She is my daughter's favorite character, so I'm probably going to be forced to buy every Holly O'Hare doll that ever comes out, but that's okay. On the back of her box, there is a recipe for a tiered trifle tower torte, and all of the ingredients listed are something to do with hair, as is the little paragraph below about Holly going to great lengths for the bake sale. So, very clever, but let's get her out of the box. Let's have some fun and take her out of the box. I put her in the sugar-coated glass playset along with Gingerbread House because I wanted to see how well these dolls go together, and they go very well together. This Holly is pretty, just like every other Holly O'Hare doll. I like this braid that goes sweeping down the side of her face. I think that frames her face really nicely. And I like that her hair is pulled up into a high partial ponytail, and it's held by this really pretty icing blue ponytail holder. And when you turn her around, you see that the hair is wavy. I brushed it once out of the box, and it goes down to the middle of her knees, I guess. She has the beautiful mint green Holly O'Hare eyes, and her makeup is far more muted, I think because of the soft pink lipstick. She wears pink sugar cookies on her ears as earrings, and she has a necklace that is light pink and I thought was maybe flowers, but they might also be butter cookies. She wears a very simple short-sleeved fuchsia dress, and it has a lavender ruffle detail on the bodice, and has a blue oven mitt, icing blue, and a very cool apron that I just kind of want to eat right now. It has several layers of icing and sprinkles and cakes, cookies, pies, and other yummies guaranteed to make you fat. She wears no leggings, and her shoes are also confections. The pink part looks like strawberry wafers with icing dripping down them. The brown part looks like chocolate sprinkle donuts. She comes with a stand and with a comb, and she also comes with this accessory, which I bet is her tiered trifle tower torte. I did try to take the plastic dome off, and it does come off, so that was a nice touch. And I'm not sure if I maybe screwed this up when I took it out of the box, but it's a little bit, see how it's a little crooked? I kind of like that, but maybe I messed it up. The stem is a silver braid, which is very appropriate for the Daughter of Rapunzel. Overall, I like this Holly O'Hare doll. I just have a single complaint, and that complaint is the length of her hair. So if you compare her to the other Holly O'Hares, the original and the Spring Unsprung version, you'll see that her makeup does look a lot lighter. And if you turn them around, you'll see that her hair is an awful lot shorter. So original on the left has the longest hair, goes all the way almost to her ankles or shoes. Middle one is Spring Unsprung, which is just slightly shorter. And sugar-coated Holly is the shortest at mid-knee. And I think with each new release, Holly gets less and less like Rapunzel. But no matter what, she's still always going to be my daughter's favorite. And so we're always going to have Holly O'Hares. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you'll like and subscribe to my channel.